finishing off how you guys did last year, losing in the overtime and the state semifinals. What kind of motivation is that through the offseason into fall camp?
Well, you know, the way that we lost or our season ended last year was very heartbreaking. It was gut-wrenching, you know, for the seniors, for the whole team, the coaching staff. We really felt like we had all the tools in place to take care of business that game, but, you know, they just Woodgrove did a phenomenal job preparing for us, and we made some second half adjustments, which really changed the game to our favor. And but it just things just didn't work out for us. But as far as motivation, yeah, it left a sour taste in our mouth. This rising senior class, they're seniors this year. They've worked their tail ends off. They're very motivated. You know, basically they have kind of just taken ownership of this team. They've really done a great job leading the upcoming juniors. You know, and they've just kind of shown great maturity and leadership, and they want to go a step further than what we did last year. And truth be known, I think if they play disciplined, they play physical, you know, we have a brutal schedule and some things go in our favor this year, I think we got a pretty good chance to hopefully get back to where we were last year.
And you lost a lot of talent last year, but now you're saying, you know, the senior class has really stepped up leadership-wise. What is showing there talent-wise?
Yeah, last year was probably the most talented team I've ever seen in my entire life. You know, we had some phenomenal kids, great leadership there, a lot of talent, experience. You know, this year, this team right here kind of resembles last year's team. You know, we lost close to 20 seniors last year, but we got some seniors coming up that have had a plethora of playing experience from last year's successful season. So, you know, we're just going to lean on them to kind of take us to hopefully the promised land again this year and take it a step further. So,
is there anything that you're kind of preaching through camp, a theme or something to, you know, help with motivation?
Well, you know, no, I don't have a theme. You know, I'm not that creative. I can't really think of things like that. But the kids kind of, they come up with that stuff on their own. And for years, you know, back when Coach Chris was here, he kind of adopted the Blacksburg team family love theme, BTFL, and the kids just kind of take that to take it to heart, and they just truly believe that we're a family and we're going to play together as a family, like a team, and we're going to love each other. At the end of the day, we got each other's back. So that's kind of the theme that the team has kind of they've kind of kept over the years, and so we're just going to stick with that.
What do you think is the most surprising part about this team that people wouldn't know just from watching you guys on tape?
Well, there's no tape yet, but, you know, if things go the way I hope they go, you know, I think they're going to hopefully see a very physical, very, very fast football team. You know, one of the coaches here on staff, Chris Lucas, says we get off the bus, we're running. You know, everything we do, we want to be fast. You know, we want to play fast, physical football on defense. Offensively, we want to kind of mimic that same mentality and attitude and go from there.
I know you say individuals, you know, per se, don't necessarily make the team. You talked about that when you first came in. You know, hey, we're still a team, a unit. With all the talent that left, do you feel comfortable at, you know, the skill spots, especially at quarterback? I know Grant did a ton, you know, for you guys.
Right.
You feel comfortable with that position in particular?
I feel like, you know, we got all the people in the right places. You know, it's kind of hard to feel, you know, Grant Johnston type of player. You know, 6'5" presence, 210 player who can – absolutely throw the ball. He's not just a thrower, but he's a passer. He can hit targets. He's very you know, very poised and mature, a lot of experience. It's hard to replace that, but we got a couple guys coming up through the system. You know, we got Luke Goforth as a rising senior. We got Parker Epperly. These guys, probably the hardest two workers on our team, you know, lifting in the offseason, playing multiple sports and lifting at the same time, and just, you know, their leadership style. They have a lot of things that kind of set them, you know, by themselves as well. So they got their own little trademarks. And, you know, while Grant was a great leader and he did a lot of great things for us, he's going to be hard to replace. I feel pretty good about the two guys that we got coming up right now. Talent-wise, you know, we got a lot of skill guys who left last year, but I feel like we got enough guys who can step in and play pretty good football for us, you know. So I feel pretty comfortable about that.